For this conference's first session entitled Overflowing Joy, let us welcome our Singles for Christ International Coordinator, Brother Nolly Manuel. All right, good morning, Singles for Christ! Before I continue, calling on the owner of the Toyota Corolla Black with a plate number 14835. Black Toyota Corolla with the registration plate 14835. Please remove your car or the police will remove it for you. Okay? All right, good morning, brothers and sisters. Let's give a big hand to our God, who is the reason for our rejoicing, praying, and giving thanks today. Earlier, Brother Gelson mentioned about reasons why we need to rejoice. You know, today, we have a lot of reasons to be joyful before our God. First, because in this conference, we have close to 1,500 SFCs joining your national conference. Let's give a big hand to our Lord. Second, reason why we need to be joyful? Because this conference is the biggest conference ever outside of the Philippines to date. Palapakan naman natin ang Panginoon. And the great thing about it, because you're all part of it, okay? This conference is even bigger than the actual international conference we had in Singapore. Okay? You're far bigger. Palapakan nyo naman ang sarili nyo. Okay? You know, this place is very special to me and to my family, you know, because my family and I, we served and stayed here for close to 7 years. Okay? We went here in 2006, and in 2013, my family and I went back to the Philippines. But again, the mission continues. And on a personal note, mga kapatid, I also have a lot of reasons to be joyful before our God today. Okay? One of which, of course, is my family. Okay, since we left in 2013, it's just me who comes here on a regular basis every year to attend your conference. But this year is extra special for me because this year, my family joined me in this mission. Okay? So, palapakan naman natin ang Panginoon. I don't know if you're seeing it on the screen. Ah, wala pa. Okay? One of the reasons why I'm joyful. My wife is on the screen here, but not there. Okay? My wife, ayan. Reason to be joyful. My wife and I, we've been married for 12 years. That's why I said earlier that coming to UAE again is such a blessing. You know, it gives me so much joy because 7 years of our married life, we spent serving God and community here in UAE. Okay? And my wife is not anymore a full-time worker. When we went back home in 2013, a year after, my wife decided to move back to the corporate work, and I remained as a full-time missionary. And since then, you know, because we have a growing family also, we rarely serve together. And because of my service, you know, I often go out, do mission in different provinces in the Philippines, in different countries. Oftentimes, we don't get to serve together anymore. And that's why I said, today I am joyful to God before our Lord, because again, after 3 years, finally, you know, my wife is here with me, pero they will come later, okay? But my wife is here to serve with me, okay? My wife has always been very supportive of what I do. For those who know my wife, because we served here together before, she would often share that she prayed for someone who loves God more than her. That's why sometimes we have to be careful when we pray. Okay? And I would want to believe that's what she got. Okay? And that's why she continues to support me, because she has so much faith in God that as I do this, as I serve other families, our very own family will be blessed by the Lord. Amen? And my wife never fails. Look at her. Talagang face of joy and beauty. Amen? Okay? And wherever I go, sayang wala lang siya this time, no? But later she'll come. You know, she supports me 100%. In 2 days' time, they'll be going back to the Philippines. And I will continue on with the mission. I'm staying in the Middle East until middle of June. And I will again, siguro for the nth time, miss her birthday. Because she usually celebrates her birthday ng last week of May. May 28. And oftentimes, pagka season ng May, I'm always out doing mission. And this one is extra special because, sikreto lang natin to, it's her 40th birthday. Siguro that's how the Lord wanted it to be, because if I say it in front of her, she'll probably get mad. But it's extra special kasi life begins at 40. Amen? Yung mga sumagot, nakaka-relate kayo? Okay? But coming here, we prayed for this. Okay? Sabi naming mag-asawa, you know, even for my wife, sabi niya, sige, hon, you continue with your mission. Pagbalik na lang tayo, bumawi. Okay? That's how supportive my wife is. She is and she will always be an extension of God's love for me. So let's give a big hand to my wife. Another reason to be joyful, here is my eldest son. His name is Miko. To some of you, you probably recognize him because my son was born here in UAE in 2008. And in his formative years, until 4 years old, he stayed here. When we went back home in 2013, you know, a year after, he would often ask me, Daddy, when are we coming back home? You know, after a year. Okay, and then another year passed, he would always ask me, Daddy, when are we coming back home to Dubai? Even if you ask him now, okay, this is the funny thing about my son. One day, he came up to me, you know, because this trip, this mission, is 2 years in the making. You know, since we left, a year after that, he would bug me. And he would say, Daddy, I want to go back home. Why are we in the Philippines? There's no aircon. There's traffic everywhere. Okay? And one day, over dinner, he said, you know, Daddy, I'm not a Filipino. I'm a Dubai boy. You see, Daddy, when God created babies, the Lord placed them in different places. God placed me in Dubai. Imagine, he was 6 years old back then. He placed me in Dubai, Daddy. That's my home. Kaya if there's someone who is most happy coming back, it's my son. He has no memory so much of the places here. In fact, when we brought him to the mission house because that's where he practically grew up those 4 years. You know, my wife, she was showing him around. And you know what Miko said? Because my wife asked him, "Miko, do you remember this place?" My son answered back with the question, "Mommy, why did we go back to the Philippines again?" Okay. Kasi nakita niya na ang ganda ng lugar. You know, and every time Titos and Titas, you know, the singles would come, you know, he wouldn't remember their names, but their faces, good memories about this place. Okay. And, you know, my wife and I were talking. We said, maybe Miko is like this because in his formative years, he was really filled with love in his heart. Okay. Naalala ko nung nasa Pilipinas kami, one day, again, sabi niya, "Daddy, you know what? In Dubai, I don't have problems." My son is 7 years old now. And this was, I think, about a year ago. He said, "Daddy, in Dubai, I don't have problems. Here, in the Philippines, I have so many problems." "What are your problems, anak?" "You know, there's ate. You know, there's, because we have someone helping us out at home." Sabi niya, "There's ate who keeps telling me to do things. She's a teller." Okay. Dahil parati daw siya pinagsasabihan. Dito kasi sa Dubai, when we were here, of course, the titos and titas in SFC, you know, we can say that he's kind of spoiled. Talagang pinuno ng pagmamahal. Kaya thank you, SFC, UAE, for loving my son so much. Okay? He came here, ang memory lang ho niya is the snow. It's so ironic. You know, sasabihin niya, I would ask him, "Oh, well, what do you remember about Dubai?" "Daddy, nothing except the snow." Sa Dubai, snow? And then we chance upon his picture. This was taken a few days back. You can really see his excitement. You know, when we brought him back to, this is Ski Dubai. When we brought him back there, you know, the two of us, he was so happy. In fact, he was so excited na, I don't know, maybe if it's because the place is cold, pero sa sobrang saya niya, naihina siya eh. Hindi naman halata. Okay? Sabi ko, "It's okay. Just enjoy the snow. Woohoo!" Okay? And my son has his own share of doing the mission of the Lord. He is to some of the singles here a source of joy. Amen? He has been a source of love to a lot of people, especially to our family. The other night, we had dinner with our SFCs from Abu Dhabi, sila Tito Lito, you know, and a few singles. And you know what my son was sharing? He was sharing about love life. Imagine, at 7 years old. Parang siya yung bida. You know, he was telling them about his crush. Okay. Her name is Misha. Okay. And, you know, because all of us were enjoying that moment, you know what he said? "But Daddy told me it's okay to have a crush, but nothing serious." Pero siguro sa inyo naman dapat serious na. Amen? Amen? Okay, let's give a big hand for my son, Miko. Last recon, we held our recon here in UAE. You hosted it. And for the first time in 10 years, I was not able to join. Okay? And it's because of this young, cute, beautiful baby. Palapakan naman natin ang Panginoon. Because 6 months ago, October 28, God gave her to us. She's our little bundle of joy. Look at her. Okay? Talaga naman. Okay? May pinagmanahan. Pag makita niyo yung mami mamaya, magsasabihin niyo talaga, "Ah, kaya pala ganun. Kaya pala ang gwapo ng anak, ang ganda ng daughter." You'll see my wife later on, okay? Saka maputi, okay? I prayed for that, seriously. You know how we teach in community, when you pray, it has to be specific? So when I prayed, because my son is 7 years old, and my wife actually has a thyroid condition, making it difficult for her to get pregnant. And since Miko came, we've been praying for another child. And it took a while. It took 7 years. Hindi naman ho kami nagpigil. Walang ganun. Okay? But God, in His perfect time, gave us our daughter. When we found out that, and you know, my daughter made while we were on mission. See? That's why for the couples here, you serve the Lord, and God will reward you. Okay? And when we found out that Sam is pregnant, my prayer is this. Lord, even my son Miko, because when we pray together, I would often give him time to speak out his prayer. And this is how he would pray. Lord, please bless us with a baby brother and a baby sister. Okay? And then eventually, you know, I said, kami ni Sam, iba yung dasal namin eh. Ako, ang dasal ko talaga specific. Lord, please bless me with a daughter. Okay? And then later on, when we found out that Sam will be having a baby girl, my prayers sort of became different. Sabi ko, Lord, one last request. If you will give me my daughter, please make sure na maputi siya. Huwag sanang kakulay ko, Lord. Okay? Kasi yung mommy, my wife is maputi, my son is maputi. Okay? Huwag kayong magtaka, ako talaga ang tatay. Okay? And, you know, true to the promise of the Lord, He gave us this wonderful baby. Okay? And she's here with us, but later on, I'll bring them here. Brothers and sisters, so many reasons why we need to be rejoicing before our God. When you talk about rejoicing, it's not only about an emotion or feeling. It's a state of the heart. You know, in 2 days' time, my family will leave. Magsisimula na naman akong mag-homesick, you know. But I have so much peace in my heart and joy knowing that in the last 8-7 days, we've served together as a family. Looking at you, brothers and sisters, you too, you look joyful. Tama ba? Can you look at the person beside you? Does that person look joyful? Let's ask ourselves this morning, singles for Christ, what makes you happy? Hindi, huwag niyong sagutin, huwag niyong sagutin. You know, sa isip lang, sa puso, umiingay. Ask yourselves, what makes you happy? What makes you joyous? What are you joyful for? Okay. This morning we want to talk about rejoicing. It says here, rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again, rejoice. Your kindness should be known to all. The Lord is near. Okay. In this conference, brothers and sisters, I want to journey with each one of you. Okay, I call this the roadmap to rejoicing. And we will talk about this. Okay, we'll start with understanding the first line. It says, all of us want to be happy. Christian joy is different from happiness. God wants us to be joyful. He created us and calls us to rejoice in the Lord. We allow things around us and inside us to empty our cup of joy. True joy is unstoppable if it is rooted in Christ. Overflowing joy, joy in heaven with Christ, joy on earth with Christ. Our action response, joy that is manifested in kindness. So we will journey together, brothers and sisters. First, let's talk about all of us wanting to be happy. All of us, brothers and sisters, in whatever we do, we always seek happiness. Amen? Whether we strive for a good relationship in our family, whether we are vying for a promotion at work, or probably you're preparing for a much-awaited trip, You know, in December, we will have our recon in the Philippines. Probably you're preparing for that. Okay. We are always seeking happiness. And it is our desire for personal happiness that moves us to do the things that we are doing. Agree? Amen? In our catechism, it says here, in the Catechism of the Catholic Church, it says here, we all want to live happily. In the whole human race, there is no one who does not assent to this proposition, even before it is fully articulated. Okay? We all want to live happily. Okay? Let's reflect. Again, what makes us happy? What makes you happy? What makes you joyous? But you know, brothers and sisters, the question is this: does Christian joy, okay, does Christian joy mean that we are supposed to be happy always? Whether we like it or not, the answer is no. Okay? When you talk about Christian joy, it's not always about just being happy. And for us, brothers and sisters, to understand fully what Christian joy is about, let us distinguish first joy and happiness. Okay? Let's talk about joy and happiness. They say that happiness is when good things happen to you. Amen? It's based more on what you feel. Earlier, when we started, you know, sabi ko nga, it's been a year since I last came here. But this is not a new place for me. But to see everyone else, especially the people I know, makes me so happy. You know, seeing everyone, the stage, everything. You know, the feeling, my feeling is that I'm really happy. But when you talk about joy, brothers and sisters, okay, it's not simply a feeling or a momentary emotion. When you talk about joy, brothers and sisters, it is a permanent result of our connection to God. Let me say that again. Pag sinabi pa lang joy, it's more permanent as compared to happiness. Happiness is a state of our emotions, but when you talk about joy, it's the state of our mind and of our heart. It's a permanent result. Ibig sabihin, if we have a strong connection with God, with our Lord, it means joy follows naturally. Amen? But obviously, if we don't have that strong relationship with God, we might be experiencing, sabi nga, yung happiness that is fleeting. Okay? O depende sa mood. If God is truly alive in us, then joy comes naturally. It's a result of our connection to God. Okay? And when you talk about joy, brothers and sisters, in a more secular definition, when you talk about joy, they say that it's an intense form of happiness. But when you talk about Christian joy, brothers and sisters, this is about a relationship. When you talk about joy, it has an object, and that object is God, the object of our joy. That's why we are a joyful people. It's because of the kind of God that we follow. The ultimate response to the good news is joy. The ultimate response when we hear the word of God, when we experience Jesus, okay, ultimately it brings joy in our life. One that is lasting and can endure even in the midst of difficulties. Last year, when I was here, I shared, for those of you who attended last year's NatCon, I shared about my dad. You know, my dad has always been my inspiration. You know, now, in 2016, I've been part of the community for 25 years now. And I've been a missionary for about 18 years now. And part of the reason is because of my dad. I shared this many times, but let me share it briefly again. My dad, before Corpus for Christ, used to live a very worldly life. Yung tatay ko, sabungero. And it's not just any normal sabungero. He nagbibreed siya ng mga manok. You know, he reigns from Luzon, pero he bought a farm in Bacolod para lang magbreed ng mga manok niya na pangsabong. And normally, when they go out for sabong, okay, ano yan? Para silang gang. Meron siyang doktor, meron siyang taga-sigaw, you know, someone who places the bet. Okay, hindi ko alam yun eh. Baka kayo, alam nyo. Okay, diba? Ang tawag dan? Okay, Cristo daw, okay? And normally, you know, that has been his lifestyle. Yung my dad, he usually carries a clutch bag. You know, the CFCs would know this, a clutch bag. And what's inside? Punong-puno ng pera yon and a gun. Okay, ganun lang yon. And every time they would go out. Also, my dad used to, he owns a horse, kabayo pang karera. No? My dad also used to own 2 nightclubs in Bataan. Okay, so growing up, my brother and I were so exposed to, ano, yung mga patay sindi. Okay? And ultimately, I would say parang one of my dad's businesses na I got so attracted to, he used to own a massage clinic. That's how he would call it. Dun sa massage clinic na sinasabi niya, every time we would go, women will be in their underwear. Yun lang, nakapantit bra lang ang babae. So kung yun ang massage clinic, they praise the Lord. Okay? And we would often go there. You know? And that time, life was so easy. You know, we get to buy whatever we wanted. I even remember, kami ng kuya ko that time, because we were still, there's only 2 of us, yung kuya ko may sariling yaya, I had my own yaya, everything I wanted, I get. Okay? But when God came into my dad's life by way of Corpus for Christ, everything changed. And my dad is somehow, I would call him parang different from the rest. Kasi my dad didn't go through gradual transformation. He is, to me, the epitome of a complete turnaround. After he finished the CLP in 1991, you know, he started selling everything. You know, he closed down his nightclubs. You know, he sold his, yung kabayo niya and everything else, his farm. You know, and he was practically left with nothing except for one business. You know what that is? He was left with a bakery. Bakery na lang ang natira sa tatay ko. Yung dating minamasa niya na iba, ngayon tinapay na lang. Okay? And, you know, even up to this date, my dad, the last car he owned before he literally gave up everything, still in their house. You know, it's an old Nissan car. Basta more than 20, 30 years na, hindi na siya umaandar. But my dad wouldn't want to sell that car because he would often tell me it has sentimental value. Siguro nga, pag mga 30 years na yung kotse, siguro sobrang ng sentimental value nun, ano? Parang may sariling buhay na yung mga insekto doon, yung mga, okay. And because I saw that change in my dad, I started to believe in the God that Couples for Christ follow. I said, it will only take a God to change my dad. Since then, I said to myself, kasi my dreams, I have very high dreams. Pangarap ko maging doktor. That's why when I was in college, I took up a pre-med course. I took up medical technology because I want to really pursue my dream of becoming a doctor. As always, God has different plans. And so, after finishing my university, God called me to full-time work. Since then, I am joyfully, happily serving God and our community. And I owe it to my dad, who was really used by God as an instrument. But you know, last year, my dad suffered a stroke. This is his 4th stroke. This was before I came here in May last year. That was first half of the year, I think it was in March. He suffered a stroke. He was hospitalized for, I think, about a week. He survived. Praise God. Then, come November of last year, he suffered another stroke. Okay? mahal talaga ng Diyos ang tatay ko because he survived that one. But the sad reality is this. Because my dad is suffering from a congestive heart failure. Meaning, nung inangiogram po ang tatay ko, they saw that two of his arteries are fully blocked. The doctor said we cannot do an angioplasty because my dad is diabetic. There's only one artery that is functioning, which is 70% blocked. So my dad is practically living with 30%. And this was about last year or 2 years ago, okay, when he was diagnosed with that. In effect, what happens to my dad, because the blood doesn't circulate as much, yung legs po ng papa ko namaga. Eventually, last year, what happened to him, yung potassium niya went down. You know, it caused him to fall down, I think, about 5 times. And yung pagbagsak niya, 5 times na nangyayari yon, caused a tear in his spinal, somewhere in the spine. My dad, since November, couldn't walk. He couldn't even stand. Seeing my... Too big! But seeing my dad, I saw him in his prime when he was so actively serving God. You know, isa ako dun sa mga anak ng CFC who would often complain because when we... Ay, thank you, Sis Legia. Joke lang yun. Because we would often complain because they're always out, you know, doing the mission, doing prayer meetings and all. And seeing my dad like this now, you know, it really breaks my heart. Every time I would go on mission, I would always drop by their house just to ask for his blessing. And I would often assure him pa, makakalakad ka. Sigurado yan. Okay, you just have to really have hope. You know, when you talk about rejoicing, brothers and sisters, rejoicing thrives on hope. Joy produces hope. I don't know when that time will come, but I know it will come. And God would not allow my dad to stay like that. Okay, excited ako because, you know, before I left, there's a big development. He can already stand on the walker, but you have to lift him up. Okay? And, you know, medyo, it's a sad reality now in the family, but I continue to rejoice because I know that my God loves my dad more than me. Amen? Palapakan natin ang Panginoon. And that gives me so much joy in my heart. I know God loves my dad more than I do. If it breaks my heart to see him like this, I know God also doesn't want him to stay like this. So sa atin din, mga kapatid, if you have family members who are suffering, okay, rejoice because God has bigger plans than us. God loves them more than us. Amen? Okay. When you talk about Christian joy, this doesn't mean, brothers and sisters, that we are always happy. Okay? When you talk about rejoicing, like what I said, it's not about that feeling that we have or emotion. Okay? Sadness, as it says here, is a natural response to pain, suffering, and tragedy in life. It is human, and it is completely natural. Okay? Expressing sadness in response to a tragic event shows that we are emotionally alive. So ano ang sinasabi? Di ba meron tayong, you know, in Filipino, we have this famous song, ang buhay ng Kristiyano ay, wow, ang buhay ng Kristiyano. Di ba? It's true. Yes, it is a happy life. But even good people like us, you know, singers for Christ, every day we strive to be good. We strive to be holy. And what the Lord is saying, we are not spared from this. It's okay to be sad. Okay? According to William Barry, okay, if you're not saddened by certain things, then you're not normal. Hindi pwedeng ang buhay ay masayang tunay. Yun lang. It's okay to acknowledge that we ought to experience sadness. And in the design of God, He allows us to experience sadness so we can appreciate joy that is found only in God. Amen? When you talk about rejoicing, when you talk about joy, it goes beyond just happiness. Kaya pala dito sa atin sa community, for Singles for Christ, imagine before God came into your life, when you talk about relationships, di ba? Pag walang boyfriend, sama ng loob eh. Lord, why me? Okay. Si brother, pagka nililigawan si sister at nabusted, Lord, why me? Okay. And because, you know, we all went through this stage when we were still young in our faith, we used to think na, pinaparusahan lang ako ng Diyos kasi ang dami kong kasalanan. You know, God would not do that. Let me say that again. God would not do that. God allows us to go through pain, allows us to go through sadness, para we can learn to appreciate life with Him. No? Ngayon na nasa SFC na tayo, di ba, brothers? After giving your time, talent, treasure sa panliligaw kay sister, even after 10 years, sister will say, let's just be friends. Wow. God is enough. More than enough, kuya. Okay? Si sister, okay, kwento ng lahat ng kababaihan to, yung fervor of your first love. Ay, ay, ay. Yung tamis ng unang pag-ibig. 10 taon na, hindi pa naka-move on. But with God, if you grow in your relationship with the Lord, try to look at this. That's why now, even if we suffer, it's so easy to say, thank you, praise the Lord. Amen? If I am not in community, I would have complained to God many times why He did this to my father. But I know it's not God who did this. While we are suffering, while our family is going through something like this, I know that God would want to teach us something here. Minsan hard lessons, but you know, yung mensahe ng Panginoon, He can still deliver that. And in our family now, He's teaching us to be strong. I remember when I was there when Papa was taken out from the hospital. And I remember, because he cannot stand, he cannot walk, we had to lift him up. And my dad, I tell you, my dad is such bigatin yung tatay ko eh. Okay? Ang laki ng tatay ko, and it will take about 3 men to carry him. And I remember this word, sabi niya, when he was about to leave the hospital, sabi niya, Noli, imbalido na ako. I'm not anymore valid. And my dad is not even old. He's only 67 years old. Okay. But, you know, in what he's experiencing now, I can see that it's bringing him closer to the Lord. And it's also bringing him closer to us. Kasi kami magkakapatid ngayon, not out of obligation, but we reach out. My dad, more than anything, needs people to talk to. Kasi pag iniwan na siya sa kama, that's it. He cannot even move. You know, one time, a funny story, because he also has a high sugar. One time, they called me up. They said, Noli, punta ka dito, yung papa mo, kasi ako lang yung medyo on the medical field. Yung papa mo mukhang mataas yung sugar. Can you help check? So I went there with a glucometer, and my dad's sugar went up to 383. Sabi ko pa, buti okay ka pa. And here comes my older brother, Smart Alex. Sabi niya, yan kasi pa kung ano nung kinakain niyo. Tapos sabi ko sa kuya ko, Kuya, hindi na nga nakakatayo si Papa. So paano kumukuha ng pagkain to? Kayo ang nagbigay ng pagkain. Okay? But again, you know, the Lord, for our family now, He allows us to go through this sadness. In my heart, I firmly believe we will see, you know, and experience so much joy again. Amen? Palapakan natin ang Panginoon. S- sadness will always be part of life. Okay? But here's the good news, brothers and sisters. As Christians, we are called by God and invited to experience lasting joy. Okay? We are called to experience lasting joy. Okay? And which, you know, even with the many troubles that we experience, the Lord is saying, you know, we can experience joy. We are called to rejoice in the Lord. We are called to find happiness in our God always. Okay? That is His invitation to us. Okay? When you talk about joy, joy will be discussed even more on our last session today. But rejoicing is an act, okay, that leads us to experiencing joy. And that's why the invitation is to rejoice even amidst the difficulties. And rejoicing doesn't always mean that you're always happy. Rejoicing is recognizing that in whatever we are going through in life now, Jesus is with us. Palapakan natin ang Panginoon. That is what rejoicing is about. Maybe you are in pain. Maybe you are suffering now. Maybe you're going through uncertainties in life. I heard that even here in UAE, a lot of our brethren go through uncertainties. But rejoicing is not dependent on how we feel, not based on our circumstances. Rejoicing is looking to God with so much hope in our hearts. Sabi nga sa kanta natin, Lord, you have turned my mourning into dancing. So even without reaching the part of dancing, the Lord still calls us to rejoice. Amen? In our catechism, it says here, the desire for God is written in the human heart because man is created by God and for God. And God never ceases to draw man to himself. Only in God will he find the truth and happiness he never stops searching for. This is according to our catechism. We said, as human beings, we want to be happy. But the even greater news is that our God, more than us, desires that we experience happiness. Amen? In fact, in the book of John, he said, I came so that you may have life and have it in abundance. Okay? And what the Lord is saying, don't just settle for what is good here on earth. Settle for my best. And my best doesn't always come in the most beautiful package. Okay? But rejoice because it is I, your Lord, who calls you. Ganda ng sinabi rito, the desire for God is written in the human heart. You know, there's a small space deep down in our being which only God can fill. Kaya, you know, I met a lot of singles who are successful in their career. Here in UAE, I know a lot of singles who, you know, earn good money, not just good money, some of them even big money, okay? But at the end of the day, they would come to me and say, Kuya, parang may kulang pa din. I still feel empty. And probably because we started to set aside God again. Here's the funny thing with us. You know, things to pray for me. I've been serving for a long time. I'm now ready to get into a relationship. Pray for me, Kuya, para I can have my GG. And you would see this person attending almost everything. Meeting, household, one-to-ones, lahat. Kahit hindi siya kailangan, nandun siya. Kasi he's asking for something from the Lord. Here comes the not so good thing. Pag dumating na siya, you know, just like in a conference like Sao, tapos medyo may kuminang eh. Started sleepful, you journey together, active, and finally, when you, God gave you your God's gift, unti-unti mawawala. Start to see them attending anymore. And they would say, Kuya, because I have to, you know, balance work, service, and, you know, this is God's gift, Kuya. I have to take care of it. Yes, precisely, because it is from God. Then you have to offer it back to the Lord. Okay? You prayed for that. Okay? You asked God, Lord, give me my God's gift. That's a very special gift. Okay? Don't take that away from the Lord. Offer it to God every day. Okay? Nandyan yung nandito, nagpunta sa UAE, visit visa, you see them attending. You know, Kuya, pray for us. You know, I still don't have a job. I've been here for 10 months now. You know, all these stories. Okay? And of course, community prays, you know, and brothers and sisters and help. But sometimes the sad part is once they get that gift, we start them. They start not attending anymore. And again, same excuse, Kuya, you know, because I'm so busy with work now, ganyan, ganyan. Anyway, I prayed for this, Kuya. But when God gives you something, He is actually equipping you. When God gives you a good career, He is preparing you for a mission. When God gives you a good paying job, He is preparing you to be generous so that you can help even more in the mission of Christ. Amen? If He gives you a relationship that you so wanted, He is preparing you for something special, not away from the Lord. For you to appreciate His gift, you have to appreciate it in His presence. Amen? If you're enjoying your career now, whatever blessings you receive, make sure you enjoy it in the presence of God. Amen? Just like a gift. You know, for us parents, when we give gifts to our children, you know, for us it's a joy just to see them happy. Tama ba, mga titos and titas? Di ba? And to me, honestly, there's this, sa amin pamilya, we started parang a habit. Every time Miko, my son, and even Sophia, for that matter, would receive gifts, we would often document. And we want them to open it in front of us. Okay? And we take pictures. Dun sa mga ninong-ninang, we often send these pictures. Because what we're teaching our son is that, you know, these gifts, you know, people who give these gifts to you, they matter to you. And they want to see that you grow also in happiness. So again, if the Lord gives us something, it should, we should grow in appreciating this gift in His presence. Amen? Okay. In our catechism, it says there, let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice. Although man can forget God or reject Him, He never ceases to call every man to seek Him so as to find life and happiness. But this search for God demands of man every effort of intellect, a sound will, an upright heart, as well as the witness of others who teach him to seek God. Okay. My son, recently before we came here, he watched this movie, yung Bruce Almighty. Do you know that? Okay. And he loves watching it. And there's that part in that movie which I also love. The part where God, you know, di ba, He's passing on His powers to Bruce. And He was saying, you can be God. And you can do anything that you want, except to mess with the will of man. Okay? And in that story, si Bruce, he's trying to win back his wife. And he has the powers of God. He can do anything. But he cannot mess with the will. Okay? The same thing with us, brothers and sisters. God cannot mess with our free will. God can never mess with our decisions in life. He can do so many things, but one of which is not to mess with our will. And that's why when you talk about happiness, okay, sabi nga dito, although man would often reject God, pero God will never stop. He will never cease extending His love upon us. Okay? God planted in our hearts a desire to seek Him. And God knows, that He is our true source of joy. Okay? Kaya nga what God does, He never ceases. He would always draw us closer to Him. Kaya nga, siguro marami dito sa atin ang kwento ganito. Hindi ba? Many times, even before Singles for Christ, you've already experienced life with God. But again, along the way, we tumble, we forget. Okay, but God would not stop. Okay, even for us who are already in community, God never ceases to invite us every day. Okay, every day to a life of happiness, a life of joy with Him. Sabi nga ni St. Augustine, di ba? Our hearts will not rest until it rests in God. And in our spiritual journey, brothers and sisters, you know, God wants us to be with Him. Okay? And God reveals Himself to us. And He blesses us with a superabundant light as we search for the ultimate meaning of our lives. This is more than enough reason to rejoice. More than us wanting to experience God, even today. Alam ko marami sa atin excited coming here. Amen? Who here talaga excited because they want to experience God in this conference. Sino rito first time uma-attend ng conference na ganito? Can I see? Wow. Close to half of you, first time. And I tell you, I know in your hearts, gigil na gigil ka, excited ka. You know, what is national conference? What does unstoppable means? Okay, what is all this, you know, creative everything all about? More than us wanting to know and meet Christ today, I tell you, mga kapatid, God desires it even more. More than us wanting to encounter the Lord today, it's Jesus who really wants to encounter us. Amen? Kaya pansinin ninyo, kahit hanggang mamayang hapon, this is going to be a very long day, I tell you. Okay, para lang kayo nanonood ng sine. Kumakain-kain. Popcorn nga, popcorn. Ayan, nagsimula na eh, oh. But as you are seated, brothers and sisters, as you are seated, remember that truth. More than us, no matter what you do, I tell you, God will make His way through your heart today. Because God wants this so much, more than us. Okay? But the reality of it, brothers and sisters, we in our human nature allows things around us, inside us, to empty our cup of joy. Amen? Rejoicing always may seem not only impossible, but it is offensive. There are external forces, no, that surround us. Probably we're confronted with bad news, okay, or injustice, or probably in your family there's serious illness, okay, persecution, or maybe now at the point of your life you're suffering, you're probably indebted, okay. Ang hirap humanap ng joy if you're going through so much. Amen? We find ourselves seemingly as empty vessels, devoid of any capacity to rejoice. Some of you probably came here na walang nikatitig na sense of joy in you. I will go there because I just want to take time out from all my problems. I will go there so that even for just a day, I get to forget about my concerns. We have a God who is gracious and merciful. He knows what is in your heart. He is a God who honors sacrifices. He is a God who recognizes suffering. He is a God who can actually turn your mourning into dancing. And all you need to do, brothers and sisters, is just sit and open your hearts to God. Amen? Okay? Sabi nga ng Panginoon, because we go through so much in life, okay, so many circumstances, when you talk about rejoice, it's not for us to understand it clearly and properly. We cannot associate it with, you know, happiness or earthly happiness. Okay? Again, it's so hard because we're surrounded with so many circumstances in life. Okay? But not only that. Hindi lang yung external. We also experience a lot of external pressures or factors that, again, make it difficult for us to rejoice. One is pride. Agree? Pride, thinking and saying, "Hindi kuya, I've survived all these years in UAE out of my own accord. So, I've been through this many times. I know I can get out of this. I don't need God." Okay? The ability for you and the capacity for you to think that way comes from the Lord. Okay? Unrepentant attitude. Thinking and saying, "I make my own happiness anyway." Okay? Doubt in God's faithfulness. You know, when you talk about joy, it's the natural reaction to the working of God in your life. Whether promised or fulfilled. Ulitin ko, when you talk about joy, it's a natural reaction to the workings of God in your life. Whether promised, pinapangako pa lang niya, or already fulfilled. It's an automatic reaction to the goodness of God in us. Kaya kung sinasabi natin na, "Yes, kuya, I'm here because I want to experience the Lord," God will not fail us. Joy precedes hope. Tingnan ninyo yung katabi ninyo. Mukha bang joyful? Okay. Pangalawa, tingnan nyo ulit, titigan nyo, mukha bang hopeful? Because it cannot be one without the other. If you're saying that my joy is rooted in Christ, then hope comes naturally. Kaya hindi nawawala ng pag-asa. Amen? Ang taong nagmamahal sa Diyos at minamahal ng Diyos, hindi nawawalan ng pag-asa. Amen? Ang taong nahihirapan, okay, pero minamahal ng Diyos, punong-puno ng kagalakan ang puso. Amen? Joy and hope. If there's joy in your heart that is from God, let me say that again, if there is joy in your heart that is from God, not out of your own accord, okay, it will produce hope. I know brothers here, you know, when I first arrived last week, I've heard of stories, brothers who lost their jobs. If I may, I didn't ask permission, but if I may, he's a good friend anyway, so I'll say it. You know the person who's helping us with a sound system? You know your Tito RS? He's been jobless for more than a year now. But look at this guy. Look at this person. Filled with joy and hope. He's here. He came here yesterday. Okay, asan si RS? Tayo ka naman, RS. Palapakan nyo naman si RS. When I heard about it, because RS, you know, he came to UAE when he was still single. And suffering is not something that's new to him. Sanay na yan sa hirap. Yung mga tarpaulin ng events natin before. Dati tarpaulin, hindi pa uuso ang LED. Ganun na kami katagal, no? Kinukuha niya yan para magamit nila sa bahay nila. Here, in UAE. He would take all those, you know, tarpaulins, and Brother Bobby's also here, both of them. You know, pero never I heard them complain about serving God. Yes, it's difficult, but they thrive on joy. No, yun nakakatawa kay RS eh. Okay, dahil kahit anong pinagdadaanan niya, parehas yung itsura. Yung masayang-masaya siya? Yung may pinagdadaanan? Parang walang pinag-iba. Amen? Palapakan niyo naman si RS. Brad. And not because he's so used to suffering, that's why he's just setting it aside. No. In fact, he is so used to being loved by God, that's why he has so much confidence that God will be with him no matter what. Kaya yung joy that is in RS is one I know that is from God. Imagine 1 year without work, he has 2 big kids to feed. Ah, 3 na ba? Ah, including the wife. Okay. But imagine, again, the Lord in His goodness, you know, He plants that joy in our hearts. We have to nurture it by not ceasing to hope in Him always. Okay? Then there is selfish ambition, hardness of our hearts, our stubbornness, sometimes always compromising with God. I will do this if you will give me this. You know, even before you make that bargain with God, He already made that promise. And whatever the Lord promises, and whenever the Lord promises, He fulfills. So you don't even have to bargain, brothers and sisters. You don't even have to say to God, Lord, I'll do this if you do this to me. No. Even if you don't do what He wants, He will not stop loving you. Let me say that again. Even if we become stubborn and not wanting to listen to the Lord, He will never stop loving us. Amen? He will never stop. Okay? When we think that we don't need God or His forgiveness, we distance ourselves from Him and His love. When we give in to temporary happiness or pleasures in life, because we no longer believe in His promise, what happens to us? We get caught, you know, in the cycle of unhappiness. Look at our present life now. Bakit kaya paulit-ulit? Pero still, I end up not happy. Okay? Maybe because you're not fully embracing the promise of God for you. Okay? When we put function above compassion, and when we make ourselves the center of everything that we do, sometimes we lose sight of what is more important, no? The relationships that we have. When we are intolerant or unkind to ourselves and to others, when we choose not to forgive, when we allow our hearts to become hardened, okay, and unmerciful, what happens to us? Okay, we lose sight of that joy. We tend to compromise our values, okay, our convictions or principles just to fit in or be accepted. And we make ourselves less of what God designed us to be every time. Okay? Every time we do that. So brothers and sisters, circumstances cannot take away our reason to rejoice. Rejoicing is not about just being happy on the outside. Rejoicing is knowing that there is always a reason to be happy, even if you don't feel it now. Okay? There is always a reason to be happy, even if you don't feel it now. And that is what rejoicing is all about, brothers and sisters. Likewise, rejoice always does not mean looking on the brighter side. Okay? You know, here in UAE, and I think wherever you go, there will always be injustices. Amen? Okay? I, for one, don't galit ako sa social injustice. Okay? And I think all of us should be. You know, every time you feel that, yung anger that rises in you over an unjust situation, maybe a sign that God is asking you to do something. Okay? And pag sinabing rejoicing, kasama rin pala yun. Okay? Joy is not complete when not shared. Rejoicing is not complete, okay, if we do not aspire for others to also rejoice. Okay? That's why even if there are injustices around us, you know, we should do something about it. Okay? It's part of our call. It's part of how we, as God's people, should rejoice. Now, brothers and sisters, okay, joy is a virtue that finds its foundation in the knowledge that we are loved by God. This is from Between Heaven and Earth. Okay? Knowledge of God. Knowing that God, again, ultimately has the best plan for us. I like the confidence of St. Paul. Okay? In the Bible, it says there, St. Paul wrote, "My suffering is not even close to be compared to the glory that awaits me in heaven." When St. Paul was writing this, he was in prison. Diba? He was shipwrecked. He was, you know, he went through a lot. But when he wrote this letter, he was saying to the Philippians, "Rejoice always. I say it again, rejoice." As if he is not suffering. And I guess that is how the Lord is working in St. Paul that time. Now he wants to communicate joy and rejoicing, you know, and he wants to present it to us in such a way na hindi lang yung fanfare of it, na, you know, you can be joyful if things are good. But what the Lord is saying, rejoice especially when things are not going your way. Our joy is perfected only when we are united with God in heaven. It's true. We become complete. Our joy becomes complete when we are with God in heaven. Okay? But even though we live in an imperfect world, brothers and sisters, God still enabled us to have joy in our hearts. Do you agree? Okay? He gave us His Son, okay, Jesus, so that our joy may be made perfect. The Lord bestows upon us His mercy and grace. His overwhelming love surrounds us and flows within us. Thus, every single day, mga kapatid, the call for us is to choose to be joyful. Okay? Amidst everything that we are experiencing. Sabi ng Panginoon in the book of Psalms, "This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad." Every time we attend the Eucharist, every time we attend our households, every time you go to a GA or a one-to-ones, make sure that we carry with us this posture of joy, always rejoicing because this is the day that the Lord has made. Okay? You know, every morning, one of my prayers is this, "Lord, today I choose to be for You." Okay? And because I choose to be for You, I know, Lord, that nothing can go against me. Okay? The world can throw so many problems, but I know I can handle this because today, Lord, I choose to be for You. And I would often remind myself na kahit mahirap yung sitwasyon, to rejoice. Okay? To rejoice even amidst the difficulties in life. Okay? Like what I said, like St. Paul, who went through so much when he was writing this. And Paul's command to rejoice, for us being singles for Christ, we can easily obey. Why? Okay. Because St. Paul reminds us that Christ should be the source of our true joy. Amen? That He ought to be the only source of our joy, the reason for our rejoicing. Okay? And at this point, brothers and sisters, I'd like to call two sisters to share in front, okay, about on how they have learned to appreciate and live out rejoicing, okay, despite, you know, the challenges that they face, okay, in their family and in their present life. First, I'd like us to welcome and give a big hand to our sister Claudine.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. My name is Claudine March B. Macandili. I've been in the community for 2 years now. I'm serving Cluster D31, Jebel Ali. Hello. Currently, I am a discussion group leader in our ongoing CLP, and I assigned as creative ministry coordinator of our chapter. I am working as a nurse in a 5-star hotel in Dubai. Yes. This is my second company. I have 3 older sisters and 1 brother. My father was a seaman before he became a barangay captain in our town. My mother was a midwife, but she chose to stay at home to take care of us. My tatay served our barangay for 13 years, but he never forgets his obligations to us. We are his number one priority. He was a good provider and a cool tatay. He allowed us to experience life to the fullest and cultivate the world by instilling on us the value of togetherness of the family. I remember every time na lumalabas kami, ang tawag sa amin, isang banda. Bakit? Kasi lagi kaming kompleto. Nag-aasaran, nag-aharutan, nagsusumbungan, at naglalambingan. Nag-build siya ng isang family na hindi mapaghihiwalay. Pamilyang solido. And I'm praising God at binigyan niya kami ng ganitong klaseng pamilya. He is the perfect man for me. Naalala ko din noon, nung nag-start na ako magdalaga at matutong maglakwatsa. He never gets tired of opening the doors for me every time na uuwi ako ng late. I never heard anything from him. He never yelled at me. I think that is his way of saying you should be responsible of your actions. I am proud to say that napalaki niya kami ng maayos at may takot sa Diyos. When I became a nurse, I saw the joy in his eyes. Doble pa ang saya nung nakagraduate na si Bunso. Sabi niya, nakagraduate na din sila, hayaan na yung buhay nila. From then on, I dream of providing the best life I could offer for all of them, especially to my tatay. I want to repay all the hard work that he did to all of us. From then on, I work hard, and then last 2013, I decided to venture my luck here in Dubai. Last June 7, 2015, around 1 o'clock p.m. Dubai time, my world had shattered and stopped. I was working that time when my phone rang. It was my Ate Chris. When I answered the call, she told me directly that my father passed away. Sabi ko, what? Really? Is that true? Di na ako naniniwala. It's just like a big joke. Kasi it's the 4th time that I heard the news that my tatay has been shot. But my Ate Chris confirmed, and her voice can explain that, yes, it is true. My father had been shot to death without mercy in Batangas, with no clear reason. Yung death threat pala niya dati is active pa. It was 5 years ago, nung may nagsabi sa amin na may death threat nga siya. He had 8 shots. One on his head, dito. One on his jaw, and 6 on his body. Talagang hindi iniwang buhay. There were no police at that time, and the place is just a meter away from the hospital. But nobody rushed him to save his life. Natulala, umiyak, masakit, and it's breaking me terribly. My world stopped. All I just whispered is, God, please help me. All I know next is that my company immediately issued ticket for me, even though I'm working for only less than 2 months with them. I also appreciated my SFC family for being there for me. They are all very supportive. Lutang na ako, and I don't know what is happening around me. All I did is just pray and ask God for guidance and for more strength. Yes, I need strength to face all of this. And the idea that my father is gone, whose strength of our family. During this journey, I never blamed God, nor never asked him why. I set my mind that this happened for a reason. I don't know what it is, but I know there is. For God knows the plan for us. During my flight, my tears are just continuously flowing while I'm praying my rosary. In my mind, I should be my family's strength in times of their weakness. When I reach home, I just stared at my father. I cannot cry anymore. It's like there's no more tears. I think I finished it already during my travel. My brother asked me, why God did this to us? I understand him because we are sharing the same pain. My response to him is, God doesn't want this to happen, but the people who don't know God did. God has plans for us. He will not allow us to mourn forever. He will not allow this pain to kill us. He will give the justice that we want. But all we need to do is pray and have faith. During the wake of Tatay, I can see the hatred in the eyes of my family. It is more painful seeing them like that. I told them, maswerte na rin siguro tayo na hindi natin kilala gumawa nito. Kasi less galit yung nararamdaman natin. There are no words to comfort my family. Talagang sinubok ako ng pagkakataon. But my faith has never been shaken. And in fact, it is threatened more by what had happened to us. Probably because my heart is filled with graces and love of God. I know He has plans for me and for my family. And I'm letting Him to lead us. Yes, we are still hoping and looking forward that justice will be served for my tatay. Even though there is no suspect, no witness, no evidences, we are not losing hope. We trust God that in His time, we will receive it. Maybe not on this earth, but for sure in other places. In every darkness, there will be a light, and God is our light. Today, I'm proud to say that my family is living the way that my tatay wants us to be. My mother is doing her regular activities just like before, attending church, seminars, and playing volleyball. It is a miracle, mga kapatid. In less than a year, we can laugh, travel, and hang out even more. we are more united. We are facing each day with a smile in our faces. It is our sweet revenge to go on with our lives like He is still with us. My Father's presence never abandoned us. We are contented for what we have now. My brother, who's almost forget God, is here with me tonight, today. He has joined SFC. I'm continuing my service through SFC. In 3 weeks, I will be a household leader. This is the power of prayer. Imagine, I just bend my knees and pray, and everything seems to be perfect. Healing is still in process, but we surrender it all to God. Siya lang ang sandigan namin. My Father is in heaven now, an angel looking happily on us and praying for us. Tatay, hello. Miss ka na namin. Hindi lang kita naisip tuwing magdadasal ako, nakikita pa kita nakismile sa akin. I know you are happy with God, and I know we will be together in His arms. I love you, Tatay. Keep on guiding us. My dear brothers and sisters, I want to take this opportunity to offer a prayer for those souls who are victims of injustice. I know this is not my family story, but for many brothers and sisters around the world. Please join me. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Father in heaven, the only living and true God, the God of the impossible, we come to your mercy to praise and thank you for this wonderful day. Lord God, we pray for the victims of injustice, especially those innocents that were killed and has disappeared. Lord, teach us how to be humble and be patient. Help us to help them. Console them, O Lord, and fill their souls with your light. Let them feel that you have not abandoned them, not even for a single moment. You are one with them as you were with your prophets, saints, and your son, who were all victims of persecutions and injustice. We are praying that justice will be served accordingly. And Father in heaven, may your continuous protection, strength, guidance, wisdom, and discernment be upon us. We pray in Jesus' name, together with the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. And for that, my brothers and sisters, may God be praised.
Okay, let's again give a big hand to Sister Claudine. The will of the Lord is for us to experience joy, lasting joy, and for us to rejoice in Him always. And today, the Lord shares with us the secret to true joy, and that is to remain in Him, okay? To remain in Christ. If we go through suffering, remain in Christ. Stay close. No? We are, as God's people, we are guaranteed of joy. You know, just like the story of the wedding feast, di ba? Whoever is close to the bridegroom, okay, receives the finest wine. So why choose to be away from God? Sometimes many of us would want to, you know, be inactive in community when we go through suffering. And that's when we start to lose that joy which the Lord gives us. Kaya ang sabi ng Panginoon, remain in me. Amen? Palakpakan natin ang Panginoon. And that is what our sister Claudine is doing now. She is staying close to God so that the grief of losing her dad will be replaced with peace and joy that only comes from God. At this point, I'd like to call another sister. I've known her for a long time, and she really exudes joyfulness. Okay? And I would want all of us to listen to her story. You know, she's really inspiring. Let's welcome Sister Alice.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. I love you. I am a product of a broken family. My mother got involved with married men. I have stepbrothers and stepsisters from the legitimate family of my father. I grew up living only with my mother and my younger brother. Our life back then was so hard. And I remember we used to transfer from one place to another since we had no permanent house to stay. My father would ask his friends to take care of us for a certain period, then sometime we had to move to another house, and so on and so forth. There was an instance before that even those who are accommodating us had nothing on their table. Until one day, a blessing came. When a certain woman, who we call Tata, looking for someone to work for her as a maid, then it was offered to my mother, and she gladly accepted it with a condition to bring us with her without a monthly salary, and the woman agreed. My brother and I were helping my mother with the household chores. I was 8 that time, and my brother was 3. By that time, we were able to eat 3 times a day. We are having comfortable place to sleep with electric fan, was able to watch TV, and to play like a normal kids do. Because my mother was not receiving a monthly income, she took some sidelines, like doing the laundry and ironing clothes every week. At a young age, I used to help her. Nagsasampay, nagbabanlaw, at nagtitiklop ako. I experienced how hard it is to live and to earn money, and more so, how hard it was for my mother to do those things for us to be able to live. We also do not have some relatives from my mother's side who can help us. The place where we live happened to be the place of my father's first family. I was 8 years old when I first visited their home, and I got used to hear the words, "Ah, yan pala yung anak ni Mang Cesar sa labas," from the neighbors, and when my cousins would introduce me as their hilaw na pinsan. There was this tukso song that neighbors and my cousins would sing while we are playing. Alis galis, nagnakaw ng patis, hinuli ng pulis, nagtago sa walis. I even heard my stepsister calling me galis at negra kasi galisin daw at maitim ako before. Pag merong relatives from abroad, my father would tell me, "Anak, pumunta ka sa tita mo, may ibibigay sa'yo." Naalala ko, I received yung isang supot ng ice yellow containing assorted chocolates and 2 bar soap. But my cousins would receive packs of chocolates and many more. I was always the least and the last. It was very hard for me, especially when dun sa eldest daughter ng tatay na si Ate Menchi, because siya talaga yung ayaw na ayaw sa akin. Hindi niya ako tanggap. Sabi niya, subukan ko lang daw tumungtong sa bahay nila at pagugulungin niya ako sa hagdan. But that did not stop me from seeing my father. It did not happen though, because no one can hurt me when my father is around. Yet, it will always be a secret whenever my father gives me money because it will be an issue to my stepsister. As I was growing up, my mother already told me that my father has a different family and that is why he is not living with us. I did not understand what it meant that time. Di ko na rin masyadong inintindi kasi I still used to see my father often. Nandiyan naman siya. My mother would simply tell me na, anak, mag-aral kang mabuti. Yan lang yung maipapamana ko sa'yo. I was able to finish my studies because of the scholarships. I was receiving before 300 monthly allowance from the church. When I was in first year high school until I finished college, I'm receiving 1,100 pesos from a Japanese sponsor. And I would also receive 1,000 pesos every semester from the mayor and congressman's office when I was in college. And when I was about to go in college, I wanted to take up nursing. But due to financial struggles, I ended up taking accountancy at PUP Santa Mesa. My father, during that time, was still into his vices. And it was usual for me to visit him whenever he was gambling. I would ask him some money for my baon. Alamin ko kung saan siya nagsusugal. At pupuntahan ko siya. Kakatok ako to ask money. Mang Cesar, yung anak mo. There was an instance, talo pala siya. Nagalit at nagmumura. At ano na naman daw ang kailangan ko. I graduated in college May 9, 2003. Unfortunately, my father was not able to witness my graduation because he already passed away February of the same year. I could say that I have redeemed my self-esteem when I graduated. They even honored my mother. Akalain mo yung anak ni Mang Cesar sa labas, nakatapos? I didn't have a chance to take a review, to take for the CPA board exam. I was in a hurry to find a job. When I was hard, even earning just minimum, I asked my mother to stop working part-time. I know that it is by God's grace that despite of all what I have experienced from my father's first family and what I have been through because of the wrong decisions of my parents, I did not hold grudges against any of them. I can still feel that my father loved me in every way possible, and I know that he's been proud of me. I don't even feel any hatred to my cousins who used to bully me. I got contented with the love of my only cousin named Diane. Currently, after all that had happened, my mother and my father's first wife are now friends. My mother now freely goes to the house of my father's first family and their relatives. Or sometimes they will even visit my mother. I even find myself helping them financially when needed. For example, my mother would tell me, anak, i-renew yung jeep ng tatay mo. Tulungan mo si Nanay Polly, the first wife. Every time na umuwi ako ng bakasyon, I always have a budget for them. During Christmas, part din sila ng budget ko. And aside from those surprise messages coming from the relatives asking for financial help. I could say that in all my experiences, I learned not to give because I have money, but merely because I know exactly how it feels to have nothing. Looking back into my life now, thank you. I am full of gratefulness because I know that the struggles have made me the person of who I am now. And more so, I know that the Lord has been walking with me all throughout. I grew up deprived of material things compared with other kids, but the Lord taught me that true joy is not found in material things. I grew up incomplete family, but the Lord is still in my heart to still dream and find hope and joy to be able to rise above the situation. I grew up surrounded with people who used to ridicule me, but the Lord has helped me to persevere in my ambitions with the right motives and still find joy in forgiving and loving others. I grew up in difficult childhood, but the Lord has let me experience the sacrificial and genuine love through my mother. And I find joy making my mother happy. And I thank the Lord for His providence in allowing me to bring her here twice in UAE and to support everything that she needs. I grew up relying in the support and generosity of other people. But the Lord has developed in me the joy in giving and helping those who are in need. Today, my brothers and sisters, I may still not have everything that I want, but I find joy in knowing that I have everything that I need. Although challenges and difficulties continue to overwhelm me at present, I can still find myself in the state of joy through God's grace. I, Alicia Bermudez Hapos, joyfully serving the community for about 10 years, proud SFCE. Thank you and may God be praised.
St. Paul further wrote, "Let your kindness be known to all. The Lord is near." Just like Alice and Claudine and many of us, as we deepen our relationship with Christ, His mercy and grace flows within us. And to be in the presence of God, brothers and sisters, naturally leads us to attune our hearts to that of God. Okay? And the love that He continues to give us molds us, shapes us into becoming like Him. Okay? His love continues to mold us, shape us into becoming like Him. With our joy, which is rooted in Christ, sabi nga, innate kindness becomes second nature to us. Okay? Innate kindness becomes our second nature. Okay? If our joy is rooted in Christ, kindness becomes our second nature. They say that a joyful person, okay, a joyful person exudes the same kind of kindness that the Lord has extended to them. When St. Paul said that the Lord is near, okay, he is, his message can be understood in two ways. When St. Paul said that the Lord is near, probably St. Paul was saying that the second coming is at hand and that he is reminding the Philippians, you know, to prepare ourselves, okay, to be aware of His coming, okay, so that when finally Jesus comes, we can be united with Him again. Also, maybe St. Paul, when he wrote that the Lord is near, he was referring to Jesus being a God ever present. Okay, when St. Paul said the Lord is near, he's referring that Jesus is here. Okay, it's just here. As he said before his ascension, in Matthew he said, "And behold, I am with you always until the end of time. Behold, I am with you always until the end of age." This is what St. Paul was probably saying. Okay? When we are aware, brothers and sisters, of the presence of the Lord, joy and kindness are always within our reach. Let me say that again. If we are familiar and aware of the presence of God surrounding us, joy and kindness is not far from us. Kaya pala sinasabing yung mga taong malapit sa Diyos, kayang mabuhay ng may galak at kayang mabuhay na patuloy na gumagawa ng mabuti. Because again, the very presence of God gives us that ability to be joyful and to be kind at all times. When you talk about kindness, brothers and sisters, just to leave you with this, because St. Paul reminded us, so that yung joy will be complete, okay, we should exude not just joy, but even kindness to ourselves and to others. Sabi ng Panginoon, be kind to yourself. Seek the Lord always. In spite of our difficulties, in spite of the challenges that we face, okay, persevere in prayer, even if we do not feel His presence. Like what Mother Teresa said, okay, let's do it anyway. Okay? Even if, you know, Mother Teresa went through a long period of dormancy. No? Ang haba nung panahon na nagdadasal siya, pero hindi niya nararamdaman ang presensya ng Diyos. And I'm sure many of us, especially when faced with so many problems in life, we experience that. Amen? But it's a good reminder from Mother Teresa when she said, let's do it anyway. Because we know that we have a God who listens. We have a God who recognizes even our sufferings. Next, be kind to others. Sabi ko nga, yung joy that we have been talking about or rejoicing is never complete unless people around us experience it too. Okay? Kagaya ni Alice, you heard her share. I know her. Yung joy that she exudes, nakakahawa. When we were talking, you know, like several nights ago, and she was telling me about her sharing, nakakahawa. No, at medyo that time, I was already tired because it was late night in Abu Dhabi. Pero nakapikit ako nakikinig. I find myself laughing while she was sharing her story. Ganun dapat ang effect ng presensya ng Diyos sa atin. Joy that exudes. Joy that is seen and felt by everyone. When we rejoice, people will know that we rejoice. When we rejoice, people know that we have a great God. And that can happen if we also extend kindness to others. Extend our patience. Especially to people who are difficult to love. You don't have to look far. Extend patience to brothers and sisters in community. Amen? Yung mga leaders dito, I know how difficult it is. Papatawag ka ng assembly, people will confirm, and yet people will not show up. Amen? I know how difficult it is. Okay? But, again, extend patience. Choose to show compassion and love. Okay? Especially to members of our community. Choose to forgive others, brothers and sisters. As I end, I want us to read this together. Okay? Sabay-sabay tayo. To rejoice means to be glad in grace. His grace is sufficient. We may not have everything. We may not have the world's reasons for happiness. But we have God. And God is all we need. For this, we must rejoice. Let's give a big hand to our Lord. God is the true source of our joy. Make God the source of your joy. Make God the source of your happiness. Kindness, brothers and sisters, is a result of this. If we want to be like Christ, okay, kaya nga sabi niya, di ba, in John, so that you may receive my joy and that your joy may be complete. Receive joy that comes from God. Receive this joy that He never ceases to offer us each day. Okay? And as I end, I want to share with you just this. Let's seek to experience joy every day. Why rejoice always? Because Jesus is offered for you, for you, for you, every single day. Amen? Why rejoice? Because Jesus, our Yuletide, He is the reason for our existence. This should always be the state of our life. You know, we are an Easter people. Amen? Hindi lang ho tayo para sa Pasko. We are an Easter people. And being an Easter people, okay, we should always exude joy, gladness, and rejoicing. Yun nga ho ang nakakatuwa sa ating mga Kristiyano. Because even amidst our sufferings, we are still able to smile, be happy, continue on with our journey with that hope in God, great hope and trust in God that He will not leave us. In effect, lumalabas ho yung joy in us. So brothers and sisters, let's not veer away from God. Ito pong gift that He is giving us, let us receive it openly in our lives. Amen? Can I invite everyone to for a moment of reflection before we get one of the sources of our joy, which is lunch? Let's first come to before the true source of all our joy, and that is Jesus. Amen? And as we pray, let's try to reflect. Okay? Given these questions, ask yourselves. When I started, I asked each one, what makes you happy? What makes you joyous? What are you joyful about? Are you joyful now? And what stops you from being joyful? Let's come before the Lord. Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, You said through Your servant, St. Paul, Your invitation is to rejoice. Rejoice always. And we know, Lord, that it's never easy, especially when we are confronted with so many persecutions, sufferings, illnesses in the family, a lot of uncertainties. But Lord, today, You showed us that joy should not be dependent on our circumstances. That You are the true source of our joy. And that You are and should forever be the reason for our rejoicing. Lord, in our journey, we go through so much, but today You allowed us to see a glimpse, Lord, of how it is to rejoice in You, to find our joy in You, to make You the source of everything in our life, most especially the source of happiness and joy for us. Lord, as we continue to journey, I especially pray for my brothers and sisters, Lord, here in Singers for Christ, that You continue, Lord, to reveal Yourself to them. Allow them to see their misfortunes, their sufferings, as opportunities to encounter You. I pray, dear Lord, for peace in everyone's heart. For love, Lord, in all their relationships. And for joy that comes only from You. Joy in their life with You. Joy in their journey towards You. Let's continue to reflect, brothers and sisters. In the silence of our hearts, let's try to look deep into our being. What is the state of our hearts now? Are you joyful now? what is stopping you from being joyful. And this morning, offer it completely to God. As we continue, Lord, our journey today in discovering more and more, Lord, your beautiful plan for each of us, for our families back home, for us being here in UAE, for us being members of Singers for Christ and Copas for Christ, Lord, set our hearts straight. Set it, Lord, according to how you want, Lord, to touch us and mold us today. Despite the many circumstances we face, allow us, dear Lord, to always go back to you and truly, truly make you the source of joy in our life. Teach us, like St. Paul, to rejoice amidst our sufferings, to rejoice amidst the many persecutions in life. For we know, Lord, that even in our suffering, you are with us. Your presence gives so much joy in our lives. Your grace gives so much hope in us. May we forever hold on to this as we journey towards you. All this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good afternoon, brothers and sisters.